හරියටත් ඉලක්කම් ක්‍රම කියා දෙන්න ඉදන් වගේ නේද මම දන්නේ
It's divided roughly in the sec. I will do it myself. In the sections like 10 by 10. Mm-hmm. So within the section, which one is it? Mm-hmm. Then the one before that is like 10 minus 1. So like if it's 11, so that means like 0, 1.
One.
Yeah. And usually in Anguttara, the bigger section after the tens is 50. So the third number is each kind of 50.
Oh!
It's kind
of. So Are if you have 5, 2, that means
me,
second Uttara 50 and
come
five.
On, ne, again.
So that means like 50 to 100. Then, so if you have like 5, 2, 3, then it's the 5. Second 50 and third chapter, that means probably like 70 to 80 roughly. And then the last number is like which one in the 10. So if it's like 2, 3, 4, that means like is in this third sub chapter is the sutta number 4. Yeah. I don't know what they call them Sinhala, but like the first one after the Nipata is the which 50. Usually it is 50. And second one is in the 50 which number. So usually it's 1 to 5 because you have usually 5 subchapters and then the last number is which number in the subchapter.
ඔගේ අපගබ්බෝ කියන අපගබ්බෝ බවන් ගෝතමෝති කියන තැයි කික් එක කියන එතන ඉන්න
හතරෙනි
අට
රිටයරින්
ඉංග්‍රීසිෙන් ඔ
so it's already recording so there is going to be kind of so somebody asked where to find some more details on the light of night of enlightenment of the Buddha. So one of the possible sources is in Anguttara Nikaya, Book of Nines, it's Sutta number 11. And so there is this Brahmin that is accusing the Buddha of some like bad things. So the Buddha always explains what is meant by that. So number 8. Issue that the Brahmin has with the Buddha was he called him that he is retiring. So then this is the Buddha's explanation. There is Brahmin a way in which one could rightly say of me, the ascetic Gautama is retiring. For I say that someone is retiring when he has abandoned the production of renewed existence, the future of bed in the womb. When he has cut it off at the root, made it like a stump of a palm, obliterated it, so that it is no more subject to future arising. The Tathagata has abandoned the production of renewed existence, the future bed in the womb. he has cut it off at the root, made it like a palm stump, obliterated it so that it is no more subject to future arising. It is in this way that one could rightly say of me, the ascetic Gautama is retiring. But you did not speak with reference to this. Suppose, Brahmin, there was a hen with 8, 10 or 12 eggs that she had properly covered, incubated and nurtured. Should the first among those chicks to pierce its shell with the point of its claws or beak and safely hatch be the eldest or the youngest? It should be called the eldest, Master Gautama, so it is the eldest among them. So too, Brahmin, in a population immersed in ignorance, become like an egg, completely enveloped. I have pierced the eggshell of ignorance. I am the sole person in the world who has awakened to the unsurpassed perfect enlightenment. So I am the eldest, the best in the world. My energy Brahmin was aroused without slackening. My mindfulness was established without confusion. My body was tranquil without disturbance. My mind was concentrated and one-pointed, secluded from sensual pleasures, secluded from unwholesome states. I entered and dwelt in the first jhana, which consists of rapture and pleasure born of seclusion, accompanied by thought and examination. Then he Arjan Hatra. So then he describes how he was progressively going through all the four jhanas. And after reaching the fourth jhana, it continues. When my mind was thus concentrated, purified, cleansed, unblemished, rid of defilement, malleable, wieldy, steady, and attained to imperturbability, I directed it to the knowledge of the recollection of past abodes. I recollected my manifold past abodes, that is, wonder and so on. Okay, thinking would come up.
Come on, negative.
So then there is description of this recollection. So, there I was so named of such a cleanse, with such an appearance, such was my food, such my experience of pleasure and pain, such my lifespan, passing away from there, I was reborn elsewhere, and there too I was so named, and so on. Thus I recollected my manifold past abodes with their aspects and details. This Brahmin was the first true knowledge attained by me in the first watch of the night. Ignorance was dispelled, true knowledge had arisen, darkness was dispelled, light had arisen. As happens when one dwells heedful, ardent, and resolute. This Brahmin was my first breaking out, like that of the chick breaking out of the eggshell. When my mind was thus concentrated, purified, cleansed, unblemished, rid of defilement, malleable, wieldy, steady, and attained to imperturbability, I directed it to the knowledge of the passing away and rebirth of beings. With the divine eye, which is purified and surpasses the human, I saw beings passing away and being reborn, inferior and superior, beautiful and ugly, fortunate and unfortunate. And I understood how beings fare in accordance with their karma das. These beings who engage in misconduct by body, speech and mind, who revile the noble ones, held wrong views and undertook karma based on wrong views. Please, the breakup of the body after death have been reborn in the plane of misery, in a bad destination, in the lower world, in hell. But these beings who engage in good conducts by body, speech and mind, who did not revile the noble ones, who held right view and undertook karma based on right views, with the breakup of the body after death, have been reborn in a good destination in the heavenly world. Thus, with the divine eye, which is purified and surpasses the human, I saw beings passing away and being reborn inferior and so on. So this Brahmin was the second true knowledge attained by me in the middle watch of the night. Ignorance was dispelled, true knowledge had arisen, darkness was dispelled, light had arisen, as happens when one dwells heedful, ardent and resolute. This Brahmin was the second breaking out, like that of the chick breaking out of the eggshell. When my mind was thus concentrated and so on, I directed it to the knowledge of the destruction of the things. I understood as it really is. This is suffering. I understood as it really is, this is the origin of suffering. I understood as it really is, this is the cessation of suffering. I understood as it really is, this is the way leading to the cessation of suffering. I understood as it really is, there are things, I understood as it really is. This is the origin of the pains. I understood as it really is. This is the cessation of the pains. I understood as it really is. This is the way leading to the cessation of the pains. When I knew and saw thus, my mind was liberated from the taint of sensuality, from the taint of existence, and from the taint of ignorance. When I was liberated, there came the knowledge. It is liberated. I directly knew, destroyed its birth, the spiritual life has been lived, what had to be done has been done. There is no more coming back to any state of being. This Brahmin was the third true knowledge attained by me in the last watch of the night. Ignorance was dispelled, true knowledge had arisen. Darkness was dispelled, light had arisen. As happens when one dwells heedful, ardent and resolute. This Brahmin was the third breaking out, like that of the chip breaking out of the action. When this was said, the Brahmin Vairanja said to the Blessed One, Master Gotama is the eldest, Master Gotama is the best. Excellent Master Gotama, excellent. Excellent Master Gotama. Master Gotama has made the Dhamma clear in many ways, as though he were turning up upright what had been overthrown, revealing what was hidden, showing the way to one who was lost, or holding up a lamp in the darkness so those with good eyesight can see forms. I now go for refuge to Master Gotama, to the Dhamma and the Sangha of Bhikkhus. Let Master Gotama consider me as a lay follower who from today has gone for refuge for life.
Any ideas?
Yeah, the only in this account, it just said, but it's not kind of clear how to use the first part to practice samatha. And then at a certain point there is this switch to we understand as it is as a vipassana to see the reality, to see the Four Noble Truths. Is this passage that is a kind of I think for many is not well understood how this passage from samatha to vipassana happens. So much that maybe to discuss a little bit on this, between these two sides of the practice, where in the Buddha enlightenment.
Can you translate it? Because I would not hit the point. ප්‍රශ්නේ අනිත් අය මේක අහනවා
අවෝ මට ඒත් නෑ දැන් ඉතින් අපි ලොකු දන්න කෙනෙක් නහම
so we have to ask somebody that has very knowledgeable about this
and mallika man yam නන්ද හින නේද
no that was to lighten the mood and bring people to listen to what is really being said.
Then make up it. May I apagabbo bhavan gotamoti? E vachane gamma.
So we should take it from the word apagabbo, that is.
Not apagabbo, it is apagabbo.
Apagabbo. So it's not like my karani like that.
No, no.
Adine.
So like negative of pagabha.
No, that is apagabha. It's in karani like that. This is apagabha.
No, so that is like negative of pagabha. Apagabha.
No, gabba apagabha.
Adine. Then අත්තිකවාස බ්‍රාහ්මණ පරියාය පරියාය එන මම පරියායන සම්මා වදමාන වදෙයි මේ මේක හරියට කියන එකනේ කොහොමද කියන අප අපගබ්බෝ සම්මනෝ ගෝතමෝ තියස්සකෝ කෝ සම්මනෝ ආයති ගබ්බසෙයියන් ගබ්බසෙයියන් පුනබ්බ පාතින්ති පහින උච්චින්න මූල කාලවත්තුක අන්න දැන් එතකොට නැවත මව කුසේක ඉපදෙන්නේ නැති කතාව කියනවා. එතකොට යසුකාස ආයති ගබ්බදෙය පහින උච්චින්න මූල තාලවත්තුක අනභව කත ආයති අනුපාද ධම්ම තම් තමහ අපගබ්බෝති ධම්ම අපගබ්බෝති කියන එක කියනවා. කොහොමද වුනේ ගබ්බසෙය මව කුසේක නිදා ගන්න එන්නේ पहीना उच्छिन्न मूल एहिते एंड तीन मूल टीका उक्कम नैति कला
सो दिस वर्ड रिटायरिंग इज यूज्ड इन दिस अदर पैसेजेस इन कनेक्शन विद द वूम्ब रियली सो द बुद्धा सेज इफ वन वर टू प्रॉपरली स्पीक वन कैन से द बुद्धा हिमसेल्फ is apagabha because he is never going to rest in a mother's womb. But so then there are some other epithets of that. So is one of them is mentioned like cut off at the root. So whatever roots or root causes that lead to rebirth in any kind of womb, all those that have been that those were cut off.
Oh, gaga multiple them and pass the guy lila ne.
So it's like this tree, if you cut it at the roots, so it's there is no way it's going to grow
again.
So there is actually this like palm tree especially mentioned for the palm tree definitely if you cut it at the root or make like just stump, it's not going to grow again.
අනභවගත ආයතින් අනුපාද ධම්ම තම්හා අපගබ්බ මේ වචනේ එතකොට දැනගන්න ඕනේ අපගබ්බ කියන එක මේ විදිහට
so then the Buddha explains the apagabba is this non retiring means like not ever go, being in the womb
oh ඒක ඊටවත් නැවත දේශනා කරන තථාගතස්ස කෝ බ්‍රාහ්මණ ආයතින් ගබ්බසෙය පුනබ්බවා නිබ්බති පහින උච්චින්න මූල තාලවත්තුක අනභවගත ආදී අනුපාදම් අයංකෝ බ්‍රාහ්මණ පරියාය මේ පරියාය මේ ක්‍රමිනු දැනගන්න යේන මම් පරියායන සම්මා වදමානෝ වදේ අපගබ්බෝ සම්නෝ ගොතම මේ ක්‍රමයටත් එක්තරා ක්‍රමයක් මේ උපමාවකුත් එක්ක මේ ක්‍රමෙන් දැනගන්න
If you want to refer to a Buddha as the retiring one, that means like not going to womb one. This in that way, it is proper to refer to a Buddha by those words.
Oh, it was the one me make a tien me kukutya seyuta vi brahmana kukutya andani attava dasava dvadasava tanusa kukutya samma adhisthani. සම්මා පරිසේදිස්ථාන සම්මා පරිභාවිස්ථාන්ති මේක තියෙන සංයුත්ත නිකාය සූත්‍ර දෙක එක තියෙන්නේ වාසි දඨෝපම සූත්‍රය සංයුත්ත නිකාය මෙතකොට මේ කියන්නේ මේක දැන් අපි මේ සතිපට්ඨානෙට කියන දෙයක් නේ සතිපට්ඨානෙ වඩනවා නම් යංගිසි කෙනෙක් මේ විදිහට මේ සතිපට්ඨාන මෝරණ්ඩෝණ සතිපට්ඨානය එතු කොහමද මේ උපමා කියනවා සේයතාපි බ්‍රාහ්මණ කුක්කුටි අණ්ඩානි අට්ටවා දදවා ද්වාදසවා ඉතින් ඒ කිකිලි පිටර රකින්න ඕනේ දැක්කේ නැත්තම් මේ පැටව එළියට එන්නේ නැහැ හරියට දැක්කේ නැත්තම්
So then the Buddha employs a simile which is like continuation or very similar to other simile in Samyukta Nikaya where it says if a hen properly hatches the eggs so they are going to warms them up and looks after them they are going to hatch so here it starts from that point so let's say there is a number of eggs and the mother the hen has properly like warmed them up and looked after them in a proper way then one of the chicks is going to break through the egg as first
oh I take it in on me නැවක් එළියට දැම්මෙන් පස්සේ ක්‍රමානුකූල ගැට උඩල දිල්ල යනවා ආය වාසි ජටෝ ගැන වැයකින් රහිනකොට ඒ ඇත්තේ මේ කරගට ඒ විදිහටයි වැය මිතත් ලක්ෂණ පොලිස්සලා තියෙනවා ඒක එක දවසකට වෙන දෙයක් නෙවෙයි
So the other simile which actually is like connected is like the almost like the first day So if you develop satipatthana consciousness, then this, if you properly develop that, this is where it leads. So the other sutta mentions actually three different similes. One of is about a hen nurturing the eggs, and like if the proper nurture happens, then the eggs are going to be hatched. So other two similes are that of in those days they use this like not so developed. Boats or rafts and they usually used to travel according to the weather so one season they go one way another season they go other way and in between they leave the boat on the shore so the simile is if you leave the boat on the shore without looking after it ropes and vines that bind this boat together they by the inclement weather and wind and everything they will just start rotting and this boat is going to fall apart but that does not happen all of a sudden it is if you just leave it there and it stays being exposed to the weather and the third one is there is this something like an axe or kind of tool for working with wood which used to have a wooden handle so the one that so the simile is like if you get new one and continuously work with that after some time it will be very nicely polished and it will have even the places where you put your fingers visible but that does not happen in a day and so you have to just continuously use it and also you cannot check how much today was worn away but if you continuously use it after some time it will be like this so as a this is like the conclusion of that simile is if the hen really watches after the eggs so one of them is definitely going to hatch
oh then make me palaveni patiya devani patiya ge ema katha manna eka ඒකයි එතකොට මේ 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 කයිසලා කඩාගෙන ආපු එකට පළවෙනි පැටියයි කියනවා. එහෙම මෙතන නෑ ක්‍රැක් එක විදියට. ඉතින් මාර්ග ඥානේ පළවෙනියෙන් එන එකට තෝතාපන්නයි කියනවා. ඈ එහෙනම් දෙවෙනි එකට කියනවා ඒක රැක් එකයි. සතිපට්ඨාන ආව ගමන එකයි. දෙවෙනි එකට කියනවා සකදාගාම කියලා. ඒ වගේ ඉතින් පළවෙනි පැටිය දෙවෙනි පැටිය කියලා මේක නෑ. අතව අර එක විදිහටමයි බිත්තර රැකේ ඒ මේක හුඟක් දීක කතාවක් මම ටික ටික කියන්නේ ඔහොම කියන්නේ
so this is like complex discussion with many points so even though the sutta does not mention it so it just talks about the first egg being hatched so in a way that's if you know the other sutta it's a if you do the nurturing the eggs are going to hatch one by one so the point is if you develop the satipatthana the practice properly after some time, one of the eggs, if you consider the egg as the stream entry, the first realization is going to hatch. So if you consider the eggs as the different stages of realization, in the simile, the hen is not doing anything else. It is still sitting on the eggs, and after some time, one egg hatches. After another time, second egg hatches, and the egg, what the hen is doing is no difference, is continuing the same thing. So likewise in the practice, you develop the same kind of practice until you start hatching these eggs of the realization.
Hmm.
So if I don't refer to the sutta, actually, it might be easier to explain.
භාවනා කරන යෝගියෙක් ඉන්නවනේ.
So if there is a practicing yogi.
ඒ යෝගියා මේ සතර ඉරියව්වම පවත්වනවා.
So the yogi in all four main positions continues maintains the practice.
ඒ සතර ඉරියව්වම පවත්වන්නේ මේ ඒ සතර ඉරියව්වට අදාළ අනිත් ආරම්භනත් එක්කලා.
So these four positions have been given together with some other objects for the practice.
Oh, satariri yawa itarak karanne inda ganwa etukota sakman karanawa ala vela innawa amma hitagena wayin satariri yawa ne e satariri yawata anitha aramunu adala okkoma ekkaw kolla.
So on not only the four main positions are given as like topic or what to do during the meditation, other meditation objects or specific instructions were given, and that is what encompasses the practice.
Gamana avasan kirime chetana mul karagana. Me gati gamana kena me rati patan tekan pavidiyala dan pavidiyachama sabba dukkha nissara nibbana e wage me dukin etara wimai kiyanne eka මුලටම දාලා ඒක තමයි මුල.
හ්ම්.
ඉස්සර ඒක තමයි එම් එක. ඒක තියලා තමයි මේ පටන් ගන්නෙ මේක. හ්ම්. ඔව්.
So what is the goal of the practice is in a way the intention at the as the start of the practice. So if we consider like we are ordained, and when we get ordained we recite this verse, it is for the attaining refuge from all kind of suffering and realizing nibbana. So if that is the like goal of the practice, so that is actually the intention that is there in at the beginning of the practice.
But ekatu vechcha ewa tamai sampajanya kande.
So is that intention? With that you combine the four positions and this
then satatate kaya vedana citta dhamma
sampajanya kandada
sampajanya
ara alokitena lekata
alokitela kannama
so with this intention of let's say I will shortcut it as like attaining nibbana, you combine practicing in four positions as well as all other daily activities. Clearly understanding when you look here and there, stretch your limbs or reflex, eat, drink, all these different activities you do throughout the day, they become part of the practice. Combined with the intention of attaining
Nibbana.
So this is, Lokam is talking of this, what is the way of nurturing the egg. So in the simile we have the hen sitting on the eggs. So what does it mean to sit on the eggs for a yogi is have the intention of attaining nibbana or overcoming all suffering, and in the all four main positions as well as all the daily activities the practice is happening.
Oh, habai thing e bitter rakilla hariyatama tiyennone me sampajanya kaande sampurna wenna thuwa kisi ennema naha man me attama kiwe sampajanya kaande sampurna wenna thuwa e gamana de ekata em ekata enne naha puggale. නිකන් ඉතින් අවුරුදු 20 ගණන් වුණා තින්න පුළුවන්.
So it is it is really the sitting on the egg or on the eggs of the hen, that is this especially this all the daily activities. So if one does not do that properly, it's like the egg, hen is not sitting properly on the eggs. So if you don't do it properly, even if you continuously do it for 100 years, it's not going to be enough.
ඔය සම්පජඤ්ඤ කාණ්ඩ සම්පූර්ණ වෙන්න ඕනේ.
So this what is called the section on sati and clear comprehension, and in the Satipatthana Sutta, which lists these all these daily activities and how they should be done clearly comprehending. So that has to be one maintained or practiced 100%. Otherwise, it's not going to work out. So it is the four bodily positions combined with this clear comprehension section.
Oh, ඊට පස්සේ මේ ප්‍රතිවේක්ෂාවක් වෙනවනේ මේකේ. ඒ වෙන්නේ ප්‍රතිවේක්ෂාව වෙන්නේ මේකේ මහා ධාතු.
So ඒක ප්‍රතිවේක්ෂාව වෙන්නේ කොහොමද?
දැන් මේ දැන් අපි මේ භාවනා කරන එක නේද? මේ ප්‍රතිවේක්ෂා කියන්නේ දැන් අපි කනවා නානවා ඒ ප්‍රතිවේක්ෂා කරනවා.
ඔව්.
ඒක සතියින් ඉන්නවයි කියලා කියන්නේ ප්‍රතිවේක්ෂා.
හා. So this kind of observing or reflection starts happening when you continuously practice those, and when that starts happening, you just start seeing that this it is just the interaction of elements or dhatu ayatan
katha. Oh, dhatu ayatan, dhatu.
It's like what you are observing, the daily activities and the daily positions that you are continuously observing with clear comprehension, what starts being seen or understood within that, it is actually just interaction of elements, or it is the interaction of sense bases, or this is kind of interplay of the five aggregates.
Ekatama digang vasanto vayu dhatu digang asang vasanto.
So then you also do the normal, what is called normal practice of sitting. So if you have the breathing meditation, this section that talks about long and short breath, that has to do actually with seeing the elements this in your experience. So or it can be also if one is observing the rising and falling of the abdomen, it's the same thing. What starts happening even within that experience, the elements start being manifest or visible.
Oh, it was a balnagota, vayu dhatu, ekama sarire, maha dhatu, and hatara inne, patavi dhatu, tateno, tejo dhatu, tateno.
So the four great elements, that is solidity or heaviness, is this kind of thing, as the earth element, then you have some things to do with cohesion and fluidity. Third one is fire, or things to do with temperature, and vayu, things to do with movement or vibrations. So all these things start because all the four elements are there within the body. So all these four start happening and manifesting in the practice. So understanding those is not inside meditation. So many people think that this is inside practice, but Lokhan says that it's like still not inside practice.
දැන් ඔය කනවා බොනවා සම්පජාන්නේ ඒවා ඉතින් මේ විපස්සනාවට දාතින විපස්සනාව කියන එක ඇත්තටම තේරුම් අරන්නේ නැහැ.
So actually some people call even this what is like the instruction is to continuously practice in the all four positions and in the all daily activities. So some people call noting those as inside practice. So that one is definitely not inside practice, because you have still not reached the level where you are getting insight. The vipassana is not happening at that level.
Oh, දැන් ඉතින් මේක මේ විපස්සනාවට හැරෙනවා පස්සේ.
धातु आयतन
बट
आफ्टर हैविंग सो फर्स्ट यू रियली कंटिन्यूअसली प्रैक्टिस दिस एंड इट इज डेफिनेटिवली स्टिल नॉट इनसाइड प्रैक्टिस देन आफ्टर कंटिन्यूअसली मेंटेनिंग द प्रैक्टिस लाइक दैट यू स्टार्ट हैविंग द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स एंड सो ऑन बट दैट इज स्टिल नॉट इनसाइड प्रैक्टिस बट आफ्टर दैट एक्सपीरियंस द practice starts turning towards real inside practice
o megate wenne araddhan kopana brahmana viriyan asallina viriyan ahosi asallina upattita upattita pati upattita pattita pati asa asamutta pasadda kayo araddho oy tiyenne samahitan cittan ekagga sokho aham brahmana විචේ කාම විචේ ඔන්න මේ මේකෙන් පටන් ගත්තේ මොකද්ද දැන් මේ මේ අවිද්‍යාව නැතිකරන්න ආරද්ධ ආරද්ධම් මේ ඉතිරලා කියව අවිද්‍යා අවිද්‍යා අණ්ඩකෝ සම්පදාලෙත්ව ඒකෝ ලෝකේ අනුත්තර ඒක ලැබුණේ මේක ලැබුණේ මේ විදිහට ඉඳලා ආරද්ධ කෝපන බ්‍රාහ්මණ විරියන් අවෝසි දැන් අර මේ මේ अंडकोसे पलागन बिताने बलवाण हरियट दिएगट एंड मे देखली आराधन मे ब्राह्मण वीर अतारी नति सम्मा वायामिति बुना
सो देन नेक्स्ट सेक्शन टॉक्स अबाउट दिस इफ यू कंसीडर इग्नोरेंस और डार्कनेस एज द पॉपुलेशन बीन एनवेलोप्ड लाइक इन एन एग शेल सो देन ही सेज ही वाज द देयर इज दिस फर्स्ट चिक दैट ब्रेक्स थ्रू द एग एंड दैट इज डिस्क्राइब हाउ इज इट एज अचीव्ड सो इट इज व्हाइल हैविंग दिस अनफेलिंग काइंड ऑफ स्टार्टअप एनर्जी दैट इज नीडेड फॉर दैट
उपमा
लाइक एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द सिमिली सो द ब्रेकिंग थ्रू द एग ऑफ द इग्नोरेंस और द डार्कनेस इज हाउ दैट व्हाट इज मेंट बाय दैट इन द प्रैक्टिस सो इन द प्रैक्टिस मीन्स यू नीड दिस स्टार्टअप अनरिलेंटिंग और लाइक अनब्रेकिंग एफर्ट राइट एफर्ट
දැන් ඉතින් මේ මම තවත් එකක් කියනවා මාව ඉතින් ඕගොල්ලෝ වැරදියට තමයි තේරුම් ගන්න ඉතින් කරන්න දෙයක් නැහැ තේරුම් ගත්තා වැරදියට තේරුම් ගත්තා නේ
so what I am going to say next you are going to understand it in a wrong way but I cannot do anything about that
දැන් මේ සුඛ විපස්සක කියලා කියනවනේ සුඛ සුද්ධ සුද්ධ විපස්සන සුඛ විපස්සක කියලා
කියන්නේ
සුද්ධ විපස්සන නේ සුඛ විපස්සක
So these days they use this word sukha vipassana like there is this word sukha vipassana word which is in English translated generally as dry inside workers or dry inside
sukha vipassaka samatayani kai kiyala kiyanne
they call it somebody using the tranquility as the vehicle and then the other It's like one group of people or one practitioner that is being identified like that, and the other a kind of practitioner. These people call this dry insight worker.
Then Chakupala and Sukha Vipassaka kira kena uttara.
So they refer in the scriptures. So they say this Chakupala, which is the monk that is in the story behind the first Dhammapada Gatha. So they say he was this dry inside work.
Mithana me veradi ketana.
So this is actually Lokahamsa's place where these people go wrong.
Oh. Samatha yanika kiyala inagata kiyana.
So then they sometimes for others they say this is the somebody using the tranquility or samatha is the weak.
तो मैं सुख विपासना केला कियाने मैं 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 के सुख विपासना कथा मैं कियाने त्याग नहीं ना तो सुख विपासना केने के ना ध्यान नहीं तो नहीं मैं ध्यान उसको मैं लेबिटा था माया मार्ग ज्ञान है त्याने ध्यान नोड़ा पे मार्ग ज्ञान तो यान नहीं मन्ने
So the usually the distinction is people who talk about these things, they say the tranquility, the one that use the tranquility, they have the jhanas and then they do something. Whereas the dry inside workers, they don't have the jhanas and they use just the inside. So Khan says this wrong understanding, because without going through the jhana level, one cannot attain anything definitive.
For bhavana karna yogya, ध्यान पहुँचने वाला, ध्यान तीन वाला, ध्यान नहीं तीन है।
What might be called dry inside work or just doing inside practice is the practice goes through the level where the jhanas are there without like getting it.
ये ध्यान के नेग में होंगे वेला पैगानंग इन्न कथा वन्ने में पैदावत देखे इन्न कथा वन्ने में विताक विचार प्रीति सुख एकाग्रता की क्या मैं क्या नहीं मैं मैं ये वापस हुई ना
सो
मैं सुख का भी पास लगे क्या ना
व्हाट यू माइट कॉल अ ड्राई इनसाइड वर्कर सो इट्स नॉट दैट द जानस मस्ट बी देयर इन द प्रैक्टिस फॉर लॉन्ग टाइम लाइक नंबर ऑफ डेज आई थिंक व्हाट लोकों वाज ट्राइंग टू से दिस ड्राई इनसाइड वर्कर गोस थ्रू द जान लेवल्स बट इट इज जस्ट काइंड ऑफ incident with the practice and the practitioner just goes on with the practice without staying
there. Yeah, pahu karna tama meten ten.
And but it is only after passing that level that one comes to the level of this realization.
Eka guruwarya me ewa gana katha karanne.
The teacher recognizes that this person might have achieved jhana or what not like jhanic experience within the practice but does not identify For the yoga.
Then we need to let that to end on a matter.
So let's say I have to go to Prague.
Czech Republic. Pempertolim bahino, Emanatang, Kelimat, Guangyaniana, Ehat, Emanatamang, Kataro, the Kohari Behala, may Prague go to Yano, Emanatam, Pempertol Bahala, a packing, and I had Emanatam, may the Lama Kelimano.
So let's say there is a direct flight service from Sri Lanka to Prague. So then I go directly from Katunayaka Airport to Prague Airport and get there in one flight. Or there might be different flights where you have to change the flight at Frankfurt, let's say. So then you go to Frankfurt, stay there in Frankfurt for a number of hours to catch the second plane and then go to Prague.
Oh, then e wage then me sukha vipassana ekkena ara maga bahin nathi ekkene. Maga bahin ne. Train patrol naththam kataru koiwa bahin ne. Ekelima Prague walta magiya.
Or even better because usually the flights they change at Qatar or Abu Dhabi so let's say the changing place is Abu Dhabi or Qatar so the direct flight goes over those but does not land there it just flies the airplane goes over those places and then eventually lands in Prague or you can land in the place and then use second airplane so the dry inside work is like the direct flight but it does not mean it does not fly over those places
එතකොට විනීතල රටට ගියේ රටවට උඩින් නෙවෙයි උඩින් නේද උඩින් නෙවෙයිද කියලා කියන්න බෑ උඩින් තමයි ගියේ ඒ රටට උඩින් කියලා ඒක තමයි සුඛ විපස්සය කියන්නේ ආන් එහෙම එකක් නේ
So you cannot say you have even if you go by the direct flight, you cannot say you didn't flow across like India and the ocean and the Arabic states and then like Greece or Turkey. So you have flown over all these countries and then you landed in Prague. You cannot say you just kind of suddenly teleported to Prague.
I think them banana ko thing eman nivey nang ke eman yanne to yanne bani eman lang itin diana. ध्यान तीन ध्यान ධ්‍යාන වලට හිටින්නේ පව් කරගෙන යනවා ඒකයි මේ
කතාව you have to fly, even if you don't land there you have to travel over those places by air so the what is called the dry inside vehicles practice and jhanas are like that so the practice does not like land there and stay there it just flows over them
oh එතකොට චක්කුපාලහන්න කතාවේදී දැන් බලන්න ඒව තිබිච්ච කියන මේ චක්කුපාලහන්නට මේ ලැබිලා එකගෙන එනවා ගෝලය ඈ පොඩි පණුවක් සතු මෙරුව පෑගෙනවා මේ එතකොට සී කරනවා එතකොට සී කරන බවම ධ්‍යාන ටික එනවා ඈ ඔය බය තියෙන්නේ මේ කතා චක්කපාලහන්න කතාවද චක්කපාලහන්රෝ දැන් මේ 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 සුඛ විපස්සක කෙනෙන්නේ ඔව් ඒ ධ්‍යාන පව කොල්ල ගියා එතෙන්ට
so in the case of venerable chakkupala anyway his story is that he was blind so when he was like walking he was killing insects and some like there was issue with that but anyway even though he is called sukha vipassika or the bright inside worker that does not mean he did not go through the level of practice where the jhanas are there
oh sikata pohama dhyana tika ena
so if you Lokanshis, if you kind of recollect that level, then you attain jhana.
Oh, make
me. Then the jhana is there.
No, oh, as if you are not doing dhyana patte.
So if you don't like reflect on that, then the jhana is not.
Oh, make vipassana kela kyanne me vipassana kela kyanne then me ena gamana tiyenawane ena gamana me nathara wenna nathuwa මේ හේතුඵල දැකලා මේ ධානවල නතර වෙන්නේ නැතුව හේතුඵල දැකලා ගමන ගියා.
So the person without staying at the level of absorption has directly achieved the level in practice where the cause and effect starts being seen and understood.
සංකාරුපෙක්කාවට එන්න බෑ, ditthi visuddhiye පව කරන්න බෑ. ධ්‍යාන බහු වෙන්නේ නැතුව.
So one cannot achieve the last the top of the insight knowledge which is called sankhara upekkha or equanimity towards formations. One cannot get there without jhanic experience or without going through or passing through the jhanas. One cannot actually achieve even purification of view without.
Ditthi visuddhi.
Because
තීලවිසුද්ධි චිත්තවිසුද්ධි දිටේ චිත්තවිසුද්ධිය කියන්නේ ධ්‍යාන
because the second purification is called the purification of mind and that means that is the jhanic level of the practice
no ධ්‍යාන තියෙනවා
so the jhanas are there
ඒ ධ්‍යාන තියෙයි දැන් මේක මේ බුදුහාඳු මේ සූත්‍රයේ ඒක පහදලා දෙනවා කියන වෙන් කරලා දේශනා කරනවා මේ සූත්‍රේ නේ ආරද්ධං කෝපන්න බ්‍රාහමණ විරියං අවුති අසල්ලීන උපට්ඨිත අසම්මුට්ඨ පස්සද්ද කායෝ අසාරද්ධ සමාහිතං ජිත්තං ඒකග්ගං සෝකෝ අහං බ්‍රාහමණ විවිච්චේ කාමේ විවිච්ච අකුසලේ ධම්මේ සවිතක්කං සවිචාරං විවේකජං පීසුකං පට්ඨමජ්ජන උපදම්බච්ච විහරං විතක්ක විචාරාණං උපතං මේවා මේ තීච ටික බ්‍රාහ්මණයට මේ පහදලා දෙනවා මේ ආපු ගමන.
So when in this sutta the Buddha describes like in more detail what is the path that this realization happened to this Brahman.
මේක දැන් හෙටත් කියමු.
So let's continue with this tomorrow.
මේක නැත්තම් මේක කියා දෙන්න
බැහැ
නේද? දැන් වෙලාව 6යි පව් වෙලා.
Almost we ran out of time and we are at the very beginning
place. Oh, මේ ධ්‍යාන හතරම පහු වෙනවා.
So all four jhanas are mentioned.
එක ධ්‍යානයක් හරි පහු වෙන්න ඕනේ.
So that Lokanshis is definitely you have to go at least through one jhana.
Oh. නැත්නම් ධ්‍යාන හතරම
or for the
එම් පවුනොවි මේ 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 දැන් මේ බුදුහාඳු මෙතන කියනවනේ දේශනා කරනවනේ මේ මේ කොහොමද දබන බඤ්ඤා ආදවන මේ විත මේ අවිද්‍යා විගත කොහෙද මේ තියන්නේ සුවනේක වේතම් පුබ්බෙන්නේ වතන් අනුස්සරං සෙය්‍යතිද ඒකම්පි ජාති දේපි ජාතිව තීපි ජෛව ගෝන් තරමක සවුත්තර සමුදාව පුබ්බෙන්නේ වතන් අනුස්සර හෙට ගියම විගත උපක්කේ
අධක්ෂ සෝ වී විල් කන්ටිනියු විත් දිස් ටුමොරෝ. Thank you for listening. Maybe you are happy and protected by the triple G.